So it's been about a year since I used Engine Restore in my old Ford 5000 tractor, and there's been a lot of requests for me to provide an update. So since doing the video about a year ago, I've used the tractor for around 100 hours. The engine has done an outstanding job. The tractor seems to start a lot better when it's cold. However, that's just subjective. What about the objective data? So what I want to do today is cut open the oil filter, look inside the oil filter to see if there's any sort of contamination. Also, I want to look at the oil itself, run it through a filter to see if we find any sort of particles. I also want to do another compression test. And of course, I want to look at how it does as far as a cold start, as well as how it performs out in the field. So let's go ahead and get some testing underway. So a year ago before I used Engine Restore, the engine would not start when it was 72 degrees Fahrenheit. In fact, it would only start when it was about 95 to 100 degrees Fahrenheit. And even at that, it would be a poor running engine as far as its ability to start when it was not already warmed up. So what I'm gonna do now is try to get this engine to start and see how it does. So in a previous video, I used a compression tester that's designed for a gasoline engine, and it only goes up to 300 PSI. So what I decided to do is go ahead and buy a compression tester that's designed specifically for a diesel that goes up to 1,000 PSI, because in the previous video, we were right at the max after using Engine Restore. Now, in order to make the compression tester work last time, I replaced all the fuel injectors in the tractor, and I took one of the old injectors in order to create an adapter for this compression tester. And what I did was I drilled and tapped the top of the injector and I removed all the internals. So as the engine was creating compression, I was able to get a fairly close reading. So the way this works is the compression tester actually screws into the top of the injector. The injector is then inserted down into the regular position. This end of the injector mounts up against the cylinder head. When I tighten these two bolts down, it gains a really tight seal. There's a brass washer that goes between the injector and the cylinder head that creates a very tight seal once I apply the two nuts and tighten it down. So this is the compression tester kit I bought for a diesel. It's not a very expensive kit, and unfortunately, it doesn't have an adapter that will work with my diesel engine. So what I have to do is go ahead and remove this top piece that I drilled and tapped and use another piece from another injector, an old injector, and I'll drill and tap it with the fitting that will work. So I've had a lot of great advice on how to start a tap, and a lot of advice came from folks that do machine work, and they said that I should use the drill press. And what I did was I shut the drill press off as I inserted the tap into the piece that I'm working on. And as a result, it went ahead and started down into the piece without going too far. Otherwise, I'd either break the tap or potentially do some damage to the piece that I'm working on. So what I'm gonna do now is go ahead and tap this. So I want an airtight seal, so I'm going to apply some Teflon. One little tip is when you're applying Teflon, make sure you apply it in the correct direction. If I apply this in the wrong direction, as I'm tightening the fitting, it's going to actually unravel. So the little trick that I've learned is just go ahead and apply it like you're tightening, using the same direction that you would as if you were tightening, and it'll go on in the correct direction. It's that simple. We're going to drain the oil on the tractor and then we'll take the filter off and cut it open. So I'm going to use an old chisel to cut into this. I don't want to use a carbide blade or anything that might leave chips inside the filter because, again, we're trying to see if there's any contamination. I don't want to create any. So what we're looking for in these pleats is any sort of visible buildup. Now, I'm not seeing any. It looks to me like the copper, silver, and lead that's inside of engine restore is able to pass through this filter, or else there's just not very much of it because I'm not seeing any sort of buildup. So in case you're wondering, when I stretch this all the way out, it's 6 feet long. That's a lot of material. Another thing, I don't see any sort of metal glitter, which is a good sign. Not that I would necessarily see it, because sometimes metal, when it's inside of an engine, it's just, you're not going to see the very fine fragments of steel. And 8 quarts of oil is a lot to run through a filter, and I really don't have an efficient way of doing that. I'm going to use a magnet instead. I've got a really powerful magnet just to demonstrate how strong this magnet is. And I can use the magnet on the underside of the table to move the screw around. It's got a lot of strength. So if you look carefully, there's a little bit of metal on this magnet. I did the best I could to clean up this oil collection bucket, but there may have been some metal remaining behind because I use this for all kinds of different things, all the different experiments I do, and I know metal gets in there. So bottom line is, I am very confident that Engine Restore is not doing any damage to the Ford 5000 tractor engine. It's actually doing quite a bit of good as far as helping improve the compression. So I'm going with the Rotella T5. It's a synthetic blend. I'm also going to go back with Engine Restore because it's done a good job, but I don't want to stop using it. As many of you know, I'm not a big fan of oil additives for the most part. There are a couple that I do think actually work, and Engine Restore is one of those that I have a lot of faith and confidence in. Now, originally when I did the testing on Engine Restore, my old Ford 5000, the compression numbers were low, the engine would not start when the engine was cold, and I had a lot of problems just with performance. After using Engine Restore for several hours, I noticed that the tractor would start better. Also, the engine just seemed to have more power. Now, it's hard to say the placebo effect wasn't involved in how things seemed, but the tractor did seem to perform better. Most recently, what we saw today was the compression has continued to improve over time. I'm pretty sure it's capped out or peaked out, but I wanted to continue to use Engine Restore because it did deliver results. I've had quite a few other people comment and say it delivered results for them as well. Anyway, I don't see any sort of damage with using Engine Restore. I didn't see any sort of significant amount of metal inside the oil. The tractor continues to run well after quite a few hours. So it seems to me like it's a worthwhile investment. What other additives are out there that you guys really want me to test that you believe really work? A lot of these additives I'm convinced are hype and I don't think they deliver as promised. But I'm always interested in finding those that really do work. Thanks so much for watching the video. I hope you'll like, share, and subscribe. Please take care. I look forward to seeing you next time.